I call out of one. I pray this devil die and get every evil thing the Lord God can give. And listen, I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Come, Yahshua. Come, Yahshua. Come, Yahshua. I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Black people on drugs and we suffering and dying. And I know it seems like you can do whatever you want to this people. I know it seems like this, but the time for glorifying yourself is soon at an end.
October 31st, they celebrated Samhain, where it was believed that the ghost of the head of the dead returned to earth.
It believed that ghosts returned to earth. Keep reading.
In addition to causing trouble and damaging crops, ghosts thought that the presence of the otherworldly spirits made it easier for the Druids.
Or Druid.
The Druids.
Or Celtic priests.
Or Celtic priests to make predictions about the present and future and prophecy and divination.
Now, a lot of y'all probably don't know this, but that one little paragraph was some of the most wicked things that you could do according to the Bible. Matter of fact, let me get the Bible back. We're going to flip back and forth. I need Leviticus chapter 20, verse 27. It's talking about divination. It's talking about ghosts, familiar spirits. It's talking about making future prophecies being in league with demons. Let's see what the Word of God has to say about this, about ghosts and ghouls, witches and vampires. Read.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse 27. A man also or woman that has a familiar spirit.
That have a familiar spirit that's dealing with ghosts. That's dealing, your auntie's in the room right now. She wants you to know everything's fine up here. Keep reading.
Or that is a wizard.
Or that is a what?
A wizard.
And what do they do with Halloween? They start playing Harry Potter, Casper the Friendly Ghost, all these movies, all sorcery and witchcraft, all these things that are against God. Read.
Shall surely be put to death.
Shall surely what?
Be put to death.
For practices like this, you're supposed to be put to death. And then you wonder why we're number one in AIDS, HIV, every sexual transmitted disease. The Lord is cursing you for your wickedness. Drop that. Give me Leviticus 19 and 31. Yeah, 19 and 31. I'm about to show you. This is all throughout the Bible. Divination, familiar spirits, drinking blood. All these things are against the Lord. Read.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 31. Regard not them that have familiar spirits.
What?
Regard not them that have familiar spirits. Neither seek after wizards to be defiled by them. I am the Lord your God.
These practices, when you're in there trying to get your palm read, when you're doing all these things that Halloween promotes, you defile yourself. You defile yourself and you sin against the Lord. Drop that. Give me Exodus 22 and 18. I'm about to show you this. You got all these movies with witches flying on broomsticks. You got all these things with them putting spells on you. What's that damn movie they play every year with the three Sanderson sister witches up in Salem? I think it's called Hocus Pocus. They play it every damn year. My stepson's trying to watch it the other day. I almost put a hole through the damn TV. Get the hell out of here. That damn witchcraft. Read.
Exodus chapter 22, verse 18. Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live.
A what?
A witch to live.
Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live. A witch ain't even supposed to live, but you're celebrating Halloween. You're promoting this. The Bible said refrain from the appearance of evil. Stay the hell away from all of that. Drop that. Give me 1 Chronicles 10 and 13. You gotta understand something. The Lord is not a respecter of persons. I'm about to show you there was a king of Israel. He was a hypocrite, just like the pastors in this Christian church. You know what he did? He disobeyed the Lord. First, he went and put all the witches and divinators to death. And then when he messed up and the prophets wouldn't answer him, he went to a damn witch to get a prophecy. And you know what? For that, the Lord destroyed him. For that, The Lord put him in a situation where he either would have got tortured or fall on his own blade. And he killed himself to try to escape the judgment of the Most High. You can't escape the judgment of the Most High. He'll kill you, make you come back blind. Kill you, make you come back and hit by a car, be a paraplegic. Kill you and make you be born in the ghetto. Fatherless. Mother's probably a damn whore. You don't know what the hell's going on. Ridiculous, because we don't follow the Lord's statutes and commandments of the Bible. Read what you got.
First Chronicles chapter 10, verse 13. So Saul died for his transgressions.
Saul died for his transgressions. What was among these transgressions?
Which he committed against the Lord, even against the word of the Lord, which he kept not, and also for asking counsel of one that had a familiar spirit to inquire of it.
He went to a woman trying to have familiar spirits. He went and seen somebody trying to seek divination, and the Lord destroyed him for that. Drop that. Let's go back into the article if we could. Now, we're going to get back into the history. I just showed you that first paragraph was against the Lord. Keep reading.
Samuel, from 31st October to the 2nd of November, was a time of no time.
This was a time of no time. You're about to find out, in between these 3 days, the laws went out the window. There was no laws left. It was chaos and anarchy. Read.
Celtic society, like all early societies, was highly structured and organized. Everyone knew their place.
So they were organized. They had a social structure. But on these 3 days, order went out the window. Read.
The Celts knew that there had to be a time where order and structure were abolished. When chaos could reign.
Where chaos could reign. You know what the Celtics started? You know what Halloween is? Halloween was the original purge. That's what Halloween was. Where laws went out the window. Keep reading.
And Samhain was such a town. Time was abolished for the 3 days of the festival. And people did crazy things. Men dressed as women.
Men dressed as women. Same thing that happens on Halloween. You'll see a sorority dressing like men and a fraternity dressing like women. The hell is wrong with you? The Lord said a man shall not wear it that which pertaineth to a woman. And they dressing like women outside in Harlem right now. Ridiculous. And you know what? The Lord says that is an abomination. Neither should a woman dress like a man. What the hell is wrong with you? That's confusion. That's Babel. And today we live in Babylon. We.
Farmers' gates were unhinged and left in ditches. People's horses were moved to different fields. And children would knock on neighbors' doors for food and treats in a way.
This turned, once again, like I said, into the purge. Human sacrifices were done. They would let the animals go. They would kill animals. They would all play pranks on each other. What happens the night before Halloween? Mischief night. Mystery night. Hell night. Where they go around causing ruckus. Egging people. Egging their houses. Toilet paper and stuff. That goes on even in the white neighborhoods. What goes on in the ghetto? Gunshots. You wake up and you find out your best friend's murdered. Your son, your niece, your nephew. Because we're not supposed to be celebrating these holidays. This is what happens when you celebrate Halloween. This is what I want to know. After this week, I wonder what the death toll is going to be like in Chicago. Every time there's a holiday, the death toll is near in the 50s or 80s. 4th of July weekend, 82 people got shot in Chicago. The hell is wrong with us? Because we want to celebrate somebody else's independence? You want to celebrate somebody else's holidays? And then you get destroyed. Because you don't know your culture. You don't know the ways of righteousness. Keep reading.
In a way that we still find today. In a watered down way.
In a watered down way on the premise. This is what still goes on today. This is the origins of this wicked holiday. Next paragraph.
The Druids believe during Samhain, the mystic veil separated the dead from the living open.
On this day, the mystic veil separated and ghosts would come on the earth. That's where the masks come from. They would put on these masks. They would dress like ghouls and wear animal heads to try to fool these ghosts and spirits that will walk in the face of the earth so that they can blend in and not be harmed. This is what these fools believed, and you're following the customs of another nation. Read.
The Druids taught these Roman spirits loosed on Samhain when searching for a body to possess. The frightened Celts would masquerade all as demons, evil spirits, and ghosts, hoping to convince the Roman evil spirits they were another evil spirit and leave them alone.
And this is what you're following. This is what you're celebrating every year. But then you want to say, oh, I'm a good Christian. That's because the Christian church is the house of Satan. They do not follow the Lord. And that's why they have not fixed us. Your mama was a Christian. Her mama was a Christian. Whose mama was a Christian. Whose slave master was a damn Christian. And you think your slave master's religion is going to be righteous for you? The hell out of here. Flip to the next page. You got it?
The Druids performed horrifying human sacrifices.
They performed what?
Horrifying human sacrifices.
They would perform human sacrifices on Halloween. Read.
And other vile rituals during Samhain. Let there be no doubt, Samhain night was a terrifying covenant with death and with hell.
Because like I said, this was the original purge. There were no laws. It was damn near like an orgy for 3 days. Doing whatever you want anywhere, no time. Getting drunk. Raping people, sacrificing children. Read.
And let there be no doubt, Samhain was the original Halloween night.
Was the original Halloween night. The encyclopedia will tell you this is where it came from. This information is not hard to find. Keep reading.
To commemorate the event, Druids built huge sacred bonfires, where the people gathered to burn crops and animals as sacrifices to the Celtic deities.
Now these fires that they were burning, because this was known as the Fire Festival, this was not only for animals, as we read a moment ago. We're about to get into what these fires were really for. What the Druids, the Celtic priests, were using these fires for at this time of the year. Keep reading though.
During the celebration, the Celts wore costumes typically consisting of animal heads and skins and attempted to tell each other's fortunes.
Which we learned is a penalty by death according to the Bible.
When the celebration was over, they relit their hearth fires which they have extinguished earlier that evening from the sacred bonfire to help protect them during the coming winter.
So they did this because they thought it would protect them. They thought their crops would grow better. They thought that they would have a much better winter. But let's see what these fires were really used for. We'll give you the sources and everything. Go look this up for your damn self. Read.
Firstborn sacrifices are mentioned in a poem in the Dinchenches, which records that children were sacrificed each Samhain.
Children were sacrificed on each Samhain. How many kids grow up missing every Halloween? Ain't nothing new. Ain't nothing different. So when you send your kids out and they go missing, no, it's because they should have been in the house that night. They shouldn't have been nowhere out there celebrating this wickedness. Go ahead.
Halloween, that was the eve of Samhain. Firstborn children were sacrificed. Samhain Eve was a night of dread and danger.
And you can look this up in National Geographic's article, May 1977, page 625 to 626. You can look up all these things, all these books. Keep reading.
The Druids would drink their victims' blood.
They would what?
Drink their victims' blood.
Who the hell's gonna drink some damn blood? They want to dress up like vampires on Halloween. You know what the Bible says? The Bible says he who drinks blood will be cut off from his people. Keep reading.
And eat their flesh. The Druids sacrifice victims by shooting them with arrows, impaling them on snakes.
Stakes.
Stabbing them. Slitting their throats over cauldrons.
Slitting their throats over cauldrons. Keep reading.
And then drinking the blood.
And then drinking this blood. What does the Bible say about this? Oh, you got it in your hand? Give me Leviticus 19 and 26. Let's find out what the Bible says about drinking blood. That you want to have your son dress up like a damn vampire, send him to school, celebrating this madness, and then call yourself a follower of Christ? What the hell is wrong with you? You don't know no better. You don't know no better because all they're about is business in the church. Pay your tithes, but the laws are done away with. Ridiculous. Read.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 26. Ye shall not eat anything with the blood.
With what?
With the blood.
Drop that. Give me Leviticus 17 and 10. Matter of fact, keep reading that.
Neither shall ye use enchantment.
Use what?
Enchantment.
Which is everything that it's talking about in this article. Go ahead.
Nor observe times.
Nor observe times. And that's what they did. They were observing times. They were marking all these seasons, following the summer and winter solstice, and sacrificing children. Give me 17 and 10. Baba Kashah.
Leviticus chapter 17, verse 10. And whatsoever man there be of the house of Israel, or of the strangers that sojourn among you, that eat of any manner of blood, I will even set my face against that soul and that eateth blood.
The Lord is against all these practices, so why are you following it? The hell is wrong with you? Drop that. Let's go back into the article. Let's get a little bit more on this history of Samhain, an ancient Celtic festival, which is demonic. And you send your kids out every year to do this. Keep reading.
The Druids counted it an honorable thing to eat their father's flesh.
They thought it was honorable to eat their damn parents. Read.
And perform incest with their mothers and sisters.
All these things are against the Bible, and these are the people you're following? Read.
Since they are men eaters, man eaters, as well as heavy eaters, and since further they counted an honorable thing when their fathers died to devour them, and openly to have intercourse, not only with the other women, but also with their mothers and sisters.
You see what you're following? You see what's been passed down through these generations? This is what happens when you follow heathens, when you follow the white man, when you want to be a damn Arab in Islam. This is what happens when you start following every culture but your own. You get destroyed. I thought hate isn't in this book. I what?
I hate. I despise your feast days.
The Lord despises your feast days. The Lord hates Thanksgiving. He hates Christmas. He hates your 4th of July barbecue. And he hates those damn Halloween candies that you feed your children, trying to pass them through the damn fire. Drop that. Let's go back into the article. Let's show you how this evolved into what's considered All Souls Day. Let's show you how this right here is what the Catholic Church did throughout all of history. They took these pagan holidays and they would mix them in, would sprinkle a little holy water on it and make it seem like it was righteous. Meanwhile, they are all the doctrines of Satan. Read the next paragraph.
By 43 AD, the Roman Empire had conquered the majority of Celtic territory.
The Roman Empire went around conquering every stitch of grass that they could find. And they conquered the Celtic territory. Go ahead.
When the Romans conquered Britain, they brought with them the apple tree. The apple was representative of the goddess Pomona.
This is why you bought for apples. It's a damn fertility goddess that the Romans, when they conquered the land, combined it their customs. And next we're going to get into the Roman Catholic Church and what they did to take this holiday a step further. Read.
The goddess of fruit trees. She was known for her great beauty and fertility. In the course of the 400 years that they ruled the Celtic lands, two festivals of Roman origin were combined with the traditional Celtic celebration of Samhain.
So they took Samhain and this goddess Pomona and meshed it together, just like they did with Christmas, just like they did with Easter. Read.
The first was Feralia, a day in late October when the Romans traditionally commemorated commemorated the passing of the dead.
Commemorated the passing of the dead. Keep reading.
The second was a day to honor Pomona, the Roman goddess of fruit and trees. The two were blended together, and the apple became part of the harvest celebration that would become Halloween.
And that's why they bob for apples. Everything about this holiday is pagan. Flip it around. Keep reading. Now we're about to show you, as time progressed, the Catholic Church adopted this. Read.
On May 13, 609 AD, Pope Boniface VI dedicated the Pantheon in Rome in honor of all Christian martyrs. And the Catholic Feast of All Martyrs Day was established in the Western Church.
They started worshiping the damn dead. Another thing against the Bible. Read.
Pope Gregory III later expanded the festival to include all saints as well as all martyrs and moved to observance from May 13th to November 1st. By the 9th century, the influence of Christianity has spread into Celtic lands, where it gradually blended with and supplanted the older Celtic rites.
Where it blended with the older Celtic rites. They combined with this. And that's why you're celebrating it today. You think there's nothing wrong with it. You don't know the damn roots. Don't you know the Lord said, you cannot make straight what I made crooked. Read.
We will hear from the In 1000 AD, the church would make November 2nd All Souls Day, a day to honor the dead.
A day to worship the damn dead. Read.
It is widely believed today that the church was attempting to replace the Celtic festival of the dead with a related but church-sanctified holiday. All Souls Day was celebrated similarly to some ways, with big bonfires, parades, and dressed up in costumes.
There's those damn bonfires and costumes again. There's all these traditions that the Lord told you to stay away from. Keep reading.
The All Saints Day celebration was also called All Hallows or All Hallow Months. And the night before it, the traditional night of Samhain in the Celtic religion began to be called All Hallows Eve and eventually Halloween.
And this is how it became Halloween. This is how you started celebrating this false holiday. Because you don't know no damn better. Everything about this holiday is pagan, is idol worship, is against the Most High Power.
Nowadays I work hard on the job, till I come cross y'all. Still like I'm a criminal. I'm a criminal. Trying to get caught, it could be your first charge. Like, man, you ain't getting the minimum. It gon' dip, squat, 5 mile run. Push, sit up, goddamn, get strong. Looking at my babies, trying to keep them doing wrong. It's too long before they grown, I can't leave them on their own. They kill daddy like he had a 30-day K. The news covering up the story for what they say. It took me back to the time we lost Otis. Pretending these crackers, they gon' tell you something bogus. And I'm thinking like, damn, what you tell the kids? We try to put up a fight, but did we fail the kids? Cause they really got us looking like no damn good. And why success got to cost my manhood?